Hi everyone, I'm Brandon Case. In today's video, we are going to focus on three applications, three use cases that really showcase Mina's game-changing potential, and are part of their plan to build a private gateway between the real world and crypto. How are they doing this? The answer is that Mina has some pretty powerful design features and capabilities. Mina's light chain gives everyday people direct, permissionless access to crypto. Mina's snaps, snark-powered decentralized apps, can privately interact with any website and safely use real-world data in crypto computing. And Mina's snaps keep users in control of their data with cryptography that proves facts about user data without ever disclosing the data itself. So while the possibilities of building things on Mina are endless, I'm going to take you through three use cases on the roadmap that could really change the way blockchain interacts with the outside world. Keep watching to find out more. Now, let's dive into the details. The first way Mina is doing this is by delivering tools that ensure that user data stays private as it moves from online to on-chain. Today, all crypto services function exclusively with the on-chain world and separately from the online world, which means that current crypto projects have no way to leverage the online presence of billions of people without exposing their personal data and violating their privacy for all to see. This seriously limits their utility and potential. With Mina, however, end-to-end data privacy is possible, meaning you can use Mina to privately access your online data and prove that you meet the requirements of on-chain service providers. For example, by leveraging snaps, Mina's snark-powered dApps, you can prove that your credit score is above 700 according to a trusted source like Credit Karma without sharing your actual credit score or your social security number. From start to finish, end-to-end, your data is private with Mina's snaps. Another exciting use case is their permissionless web oracles. With Mina's permissionless web oracles, devs can leverage private, verified, real-world data from any website using HTTPS, such as the NASDAQ, onto the blockchain to build decentralized apps. Unique to Mina, web oracles can be both permissionless and verifiable, two features essential to aiding in the transition from centralized data sources to decentralized information. That means you can input any information that is publicly available on the web without needing that website's permission. And the network can prove and verify that the information was indeed sourced accurately. For creators out there, this could mean that if a tweet reaches a specific number of likes, it triggers a smart contract to mint an NFT. This is cool, right? Mina's snaps will allow this without needing an agreement from Twitter or any other public site. Finally, with Mina, you can access any internet website or service privately without creating an account and handing over your data. Instead, you could log in securely with Mina. Other crypto projects claim to have one private login capabilities, but theirs are constrained within the crypto ecosystem. But Mina will work across the internet. Think about it. How many times have you handed over your personal data, like your email or your credit card info, to a company to use their services? Apple, for example, offers users a centralized login, but it's not private or censorship resistant. Mina's one private internet login solution is different. You'll create snap-based login accounts on Mina using your email. The snap will prove to the website that you own the underlying email without ever revealing your actual address, giving you control of your data again. These examples are only the beginning of what's possible on Mina. If you care about decentralized, permissionless blockchain integrity and your data privacy, then snaps are the best place to start. You can follow @MinaProtocol on Twitter to stay updated on these exciting new use cases and more. So that's it for today's video. Please give it a like down below and let me know, what are some things you'd like to build on Mina with end-to-end data privacy and permissionless web oracles? Drop your ideas in the comments below, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. See ya.